Okay, so hello again, everybody. I'm back at ground zero where the riots started here in Minneapolis over 2 weeks ago now. And we're going to survey some damage, some aftermath. This is the former post office, which was burnt down, as you can see. What a wreck. Everything's fenced off. It feels really desolate out here. Everything's boarded up. Jesus. And you might be watching this video and think this is a really bad neighborhood, looking at the wrecked buildings and the boarded up shops. This used to be a really nice area. Everything is wrecked. Look at that pile of debris. This was the old Nuevo Laredo, or Nuevo Rodeo. Restaurant and club, completely burnt down, completely torn down, just a big pile of rubble. There's the building I explored in one of my last videos. If you haven't seen that one, you should watch it. It's got a really crazy labyrinth-like basement. And it looks even worse than when I was out here, last time I was out here a couple weeks ago. Everything is smashed out on there. This burnt out patch of rubble used to be a pawn shop. Lake Street is still blocked off down here. Man, really sad. Honestly, I'm really glad I don't live in this city anymore, because it's just going to get a lot worse. I don't think these places are going to rebuild or reopen. I mean, why would you? It's a total liability to be out here now. It's like a huge scar on the city. God, they just trashed the shit out of this place. I don't know if you can see it in the video or not, but there's still broken glass on the street, on the sidewalk here. used to be a Denny's restaurant on the corner here. Is destruction everywhere you look, every single direction over here. This used to be the AutoZone auto parts store. This is where all the violence and mayhem started. Shop next door. That shop on the corner used to have a really nice Asian restaurant. I think it was like Japanese. Right into their basement. Bunch of free beer down there if anybody wants some. I sure don't trust it though. And let's go walk back over here. So the rubble directly in front of me used to be a Wendy's restaurant. No more hamburgers and chicken sandwiches for anybody from there. I love those chicken sandwiches. Boarded up strip mall. The building on the left here was also one of the first buildings to get torched at the start of the riots. This was a low-income housing site. Get it now. got rid of the burnt out cars and trucks on the street at least, so that's nice to start. This just blows my frickin' mind. Cannot even believe that this happened. Serious, I used to live like 4 blocks away from here. Like, this was my neighborhood. Cleaned up the Target a little bit. Whole parking lot is blocked off here. That's the old Cub Foods. That's where I used to do my grocery shopping when I lived over here. Seriously, this is just heartbreaking. So I had heard a few years back that Target company wanted to close this location because it was one of their least profitable locations and there was a lot of shoplifting here. But it looks like they're going to rebuild it. Painted over all the graffiti, cleaned up the garbage, residue left over from the riots. Last time I was here, this place was thrown wide open. People running in and out, grabbing whatever they can. Just blows my mind. This is normally such a nice, calm city. Flattened pile of rubble. It used to be the Arby's. So there's a fence around all these burned out sites. I can't really get back in there, but I hope you all can see that. That is what's left of the Arby's. There's the sign. Sorry, that's about the best angle I can get. And there is the now infamous Minneapolis 3rd Precinct. See much because the fence and the trees don't let me get any closer. So hang on a sec, let's get a different angle. There's the front of the precinct. Those cement blocks used to be the front door. and that's the liquor store, burnt out shell. Thank you once again, everybody, for watching. I hope you enjoyed that video. I had a lot of fun making it. Before I go here, I want to mention to check out my picture books, postcards, and stickers on my Etsy site, lipacoindustries@etsy.com. I have dozens of titles available. Wonderful, colorful picture books with amazing photos of strange and weird places, abandoned places from all over the world. Looks great on your coffee table, great on your bookshelf. Buy one for your mom. Get some for your friends. Thanks for watching again.